Hello, folks. You are listening to episode number 22 of Con Talk. This time, we're going to be discussing the Día de los Muertos Paranormal Conference that took place on November 2nd, 2013, at the Emily Morgan Hotel in downtown San Antonio. This is a different kind of event for myself, Eduardo Soliz, and my co-host, Chris Holm.
Hey, how's it going, kids?
And that it was a paranormal conference. Now, I'll be honest with you, my exposure to the paranormal is fairly limited. And in the interest of full disclosure, my cousin, Linda Gonzalez, is heavily involved in the event. And what little I do know about the paranormal, I've learned from her, you know, because she's really into it. We did receive free passes to this event.
Yeah, that's how we heard about the event in the first place. It probably isn't something that we would normally be covering.
Yeah, definitely. You know, because it's not pop culture or anime or comics or even furry, for that matter. You know, my understanding, Chris, is that you're kind of a little bit into, you know, this kind of stuff, or rather, you knew who some of the guests were.
Yeah, I mean, I always have an interest in the paranormal and paranormal investigating. So I was like, you know, well, if this is going on, you know, let's take a shot and see if we can get in. And they, of course, mm-hmm. graciously let us in. So why not just take it in for what it is?
I'm flying blind. You know, I know practically zero. You know, my cousin has talked to me about EVPs and these investigations that she does and things of that nature. But I myself just, you know, and I've seen, an episode of Ghost whatever on the television. But other than that, I mean, like I said, I'm flying blind. I'm a newbie. I don't know anything about this kind of stuff. So I was kind of looking to Chris to guide me a little bit, you know,
into the
world
familiar.
Of the paranormal. Ooh.
I'm familiar with most of the guests. The one I'm most familiar with is Ken Gearhart, who's a cryptozoologist. My exposure has been through the paranormal, has been through, you know, late night talk shows like Coast to Coast AM or Ground Zero with Clyde Lewis. You know, it's these late night friend shows and sort of these, you know, the paranormal late night stuff. It's very enjoyable. You know, I really do enjoy it. You know, I like, mm-hmm. you know, Bigfoot stories and Chupacabra stories and all that stuff. And that's, you know, what really perked my ears up in this whole, you know, well, if this is going on, let's check it out.
Yeah, and also, you know, one thing that should be worth mentioning, one thing I learned is that when we talk about paranormal, it isn't necessarily just ghosts. You know, it's kind of anything that's really out of the ordinary. You know, stuff like, you know, Bigfoot and animals that, you know, maybe we've never seen or heard of or things of that nature, like, you know, chupacabras and so on and so forth. So, yes, they had, you know, a lot of guests that had things to do with ghosts and things of that nature. But, you know, from what I understand, they also covered a lot of other bases of the paranormal.
In addition to ghost hunting, mm-hmm. which they had quite a number of nationally recognized presenters and guests of, mm-hmm. they also had psychic mediums. They also had Ouija board readers. They also had, you know, crystal therapy or something of that nature. I saw quite a bit of different stuff cater to, you know, a wide range of stuff, not just ghost hunting.
Yeah,
although ghost hunting was the predominant theme of this conference.
Yeah, we're getting a bit ahead of ourselves, though, so let's go ahead and start at the beginning. The one thing that kind of turned me off initially when I first heard about the event was the ticket prices. If you pre-registered, keep in mind, I mean, I know nothing about these things, so I don't know if this is a normal thing or whatnot, but it was $80 to pre-register for the event and $100 at the door. To put that into perspective, I mean, Alamo City Comic-Con was, what, 45 for all three days?
It was 65.
Yeah, 65 for all 3 days for that one. San Japan, I think, was 45. You know, and that's for a three-day event, so to charge $80 for a one-day thing, you know, that kind of just made me go,
trying to put this in perspective, this is more of a conference rather than a convention. I mean, you're not going there for, you know, artists or, you know, to get, you know, the latest ghost plushie. Although they do have those there, it's just, this is something more intimate, you know, environment where you're going to have face time with the majority of these guests.
Well, and it's serious. I mean, you know, these people take what they do seriously, and, you know, there was a lot of, you know, good information, you know, even if you're a skeptic or whatnot, you know, or you're new to the whole thing like me. I mean, you know, you'll learn something about, you know, these different paranormal disciplines, or I'm not sure what you would call
it. Yeah, I guess that would be the best word for it we can use right now. Yeah, I'd say it's a good place to mix with the guests. And also, you know, these are nationally recognized guests.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much every show, I'm pretty sure even the Food Network has its own ghost hunting show. And these were guests from various networks of ghost hunting shows, such as the Kimball Brothers, Ken Gearhart, Russell Rush, you know, just to name off a few who have, you know, shows that are playing on networks or have been guests of network shows. And various, even Coast to Coast AM, they've been guests. This is, you know, you're paying, you know, just to get in with them. And also in the $100 mark of the ticket prices also included an investigation, you know, an in-depth investigation. So you get to sort of ride along. This is like if you're a really big fan of Cops, you know, you go to here and then they'll let you ride along with one of the cops or something. So if you're really into it, then that definitely would be worth it because you get, you know, firsthand field experience with some of these people.
Yeah, and that was a ghost hunt that they had at the actual, at a hotel, at the Emily Morgan Hotel, which apparently, you know, it's a pretty old building, and apparently there are some things, you know,
still go bump in the night.
Still hanging around, yep. Some uninvited guests that just never checked out. Or maybe they did, who knows. So yeah, I mean, that was another thing, and they also had another ghost hunt that took place over in the...
I think it was Helena, Texas?
Yeah, the town of Helena, Texas. And that was with Andy and Michelle Kopach.
Not sure yeah, so they were right. Pretty much were offering two ghost hunts, I believe.
Yeah, that's correct. And so yeah, I mean, if you... There was an opportunity there to, you know, get your feet wet and actually go on a, you know, ghost hunt with, you know, some of these recognized figures. Yeah, so that's pretty neat.
Yeah, that's pretty much similar to, like, say, if you're into anime, you know, getting to dub an anime episode with your favorite anime artist, or if you're a comic book artist, you get to, like, sit there and draw with your favorite comic book artist or something like that. And, you know, this is sort of like, you know, you get to go along on an adventure and they're going to hold your hand the whole way. So this is sort of, I mean, so for that, I'd say,
that's neat.
That's
something different, something you don't necessarily see.
You're not going to get that at a large, largely attended conference. So this was more intimate. This was more, you know, if you're really into this, this is where you go to network. This is where you go to you know, compare notes with other people that are seriously into the field that you are in.
Yeah, or just, you know, go up and ask questions. I mean, I had a question for Ken Gearhart about the camels, you know, because he talked about, you know, animals that have been displaced that weren't where they were supposed to be. And I asked him, so, well, what about the camel thing I keep hearing about? It? I heard that, you know, the U.S. Army was, like, testing using camels as pack animals, like, in the 20s and 30s out in the Texas desert or New Mexico or somewhere. You know, it didn't work out, or they ended the experiment and they just said, screw it, and just let the camels free. And now there's like camels roaming the deserts of the southwestern U.S. somewhere. And he said, yeah, that's true, that there actually was a experiment that the Army did. And yeah, when they were done, they, well, later dudes, and they just let the camels free. So that was neat to, you know, to talk about that.
I guess we noticed during the panels of the event, which was really, you know, a big draw for me, which is what I enjoyed most, was the panels.
Oh, yeah.
Is that everybody, you know, has this sort of... They did have a few comedy people there. You know, I mean, Russell Rush, he was okay, but he, you know, he was more of a comedy type of person, you know, along with the... with his serious investigation. He had thrown in a lot of jokes in there. And then there was this other comedy troupe. I forget what their name is, but they were specifically a parody group of the paranormal, and they came out from California, and their show or presentation was more fun and games.
Oh, okay. I think I missed that one.
Yeah, that was the guy in the orange pants.
Nice.
You know, who has a shirt on that says Parahor. I, off the top of my head, I really can't think of his name or anything. But on to the serious stuff, what I really liked about the panels is it was more in-depth, and all the, you got a chance to really go back and forth with the investigators.
Yeah, I mean, they were very small groups. I think the room probably would have held, I think, maybe 50 people at most.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and you know, they had there were, you know, probably filled about halfway, you know, to two-thirds full for most of the panels, which was good. I mean,
yeah, it was a very good crowd. It was sort of, it was kind of slow at first, but as the day got on later, it sort of built up momentum, and by the end of the day, it was, you know, bustling with activity.
Yeah, especially when the zombies came rolling by.
Yeah, zombies as presented by the 13th floor, which is a haunted house. They came in and you know, people dressed up as zombies for that, and it was good, and it was fun.
Yeah, very well done, too. I mean, that was some really, really very good, well done, you know, makeup and things of that nature. Yeah, yeah. Definitely added a little, you know, a little something to the event.
Yeah, and with the panels, what I liked most was that, you know, you had a chance to really get involved and ask good questions. And as people presented their evidence, that evidence, of course, was cross-examined by attending by the audience.
Yeah, and that was one thing that impressed me. Because once again, I mean, I'm new to this. I'm flying blind. And so I remember particularly during, you know, Russell Rush's panel, you know, he would, you know, play an EVP or show a video of some kind. And you would expect, you know, because this is the, you know, the target audience for this sort of thing. You would expect everybody to go, oh, my God, a ghost, you know, and, you know, that's proof, you know, whatever, whatever. But they didn't. They, you know, they legitimately questioned what the evidence was, you know, the shadow on the wall. You know, somebody asked, is there a window in the room? Were there curtains? You know, was there somebody, did somebody have a light? Was there a legitimate, logical, you know, scientific reason for that shadow?
Yeah, not everything is taken at face value.
Yeah, exactly.
And, you know, everything is like cross-examined. And this is a lot of, you know, documentation and proof, particularly during Ken Gearhart's panel. When he was presenting his stuff, he had lots of slides of news clippings from various newspapers. He had, you know, a lot of evidence that he had taken down, testimonials, you know. And he explained up front, you know, a lot of this is anecdotal evidence, but this is what's been documented, and this is what we're looking at, and we're going out there and looking for, you know, these various, this evidence and what we're looking for.
Yeah, and taking, you know, taking tissue samples and getting, you know, DNA analyzed. The one I remember distinctly, because I showed up to that one near the end, was the Chupacabras, you know, where they, at least a couple of them, two or three of them, you know, they had ended up being, you know, some type of domesticated dog.
Yeah, it's just diseased.
That had, yeah, some kind of weird type of mange or something, yeah, that just made all their hair fall out. And
yeah, it was like a diseased dog, and there was, you know, a logical explanation for it. But, mm-hmm, you know, there was like a lot of, I guess, mass hysteria that sort of got a bit out of hand, and it became an urban legend.
Exactly. You know, so yeah, I mean, it was cool to see that. You know, because even, like I said, even if you're, you know, you're not a believer or, you know, whatever, whatever, it's good to see.
Yeah, I mean, I really did enjoy it. It was very good, very well done show.
Yeah, I liked it, and you know, and they had some vendors. They had a lot of interesting stuff to sell. You know, whether it was, I have a friend, Joe Garcia. He has a T-shirt shop in Corpus Christi called Fast Custom Shirts. He was there selling, you know, horror T-shirts, which, you know, kind of suits the crowd. And he also had some Dia de los Muertos, you know, skull designs, which is, you know, pretty neat. They had folks selling, you know, crystals. I think there were some paranormal groups there as well. All of the guests had tables where they were, you know, selling books and their merchandise. You know, so, yeah.
Yeah, I bought a couple books from Ken Gearhart, and I was just looking around, and there's a lot of good stuff. I picked up some stuff from the Virginia Paranormal Society there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I said, a lot of neat things, a lot of interesting things to see that you don't normally see at, you know, a pop culture, you know, type of convention. You know, and that was cool.
Yeah, I've heard about shows like these happening in mostly in Dallas,
right,
and up in northern Texas. As far as where they're happening in San Antonio, I haven't quite heard too much, or I just haven't come across that news feed yet. Or it just hasn't passed by my desk.
Right.
But to see this kind of event happening here, I hope it opens up for more events of this nature.
Yeah, I mean, it's something different. I mean, and there definitely is an audience for, you know, for this kind of thing. And as a bit of an aside here, I think it's interesting, you know, something that I kind of noticed driving around downtown is that Dia de los Muertos is apparently, you know, becoming a thing now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, much in the same way that other holidays from other countries like St. Patrick's Day, and I'll even throw in Cinco de Mayo there for good measure, are kind of becoming adopted by the United States, or at least Texas, as, you know, another excuse to party. You know, Dia de los Muertos, which is the Mexican Day of the Dead, you know, November 1st is kind of becoming that, because I could see, you know, people with the skull, you know, makeup on, and, you know, even outside the conference, you know, just, you know, having fun. And,
yeah, I mean, San Antonio was having its own De Los Muertos Day festival events going on, and in the conference, you could get painted up. Mm-hmm. And then go out downtown and hit the town and enjoy the festivities.
Yeah, like I said, I just think it's interesting that, you know, probably partially because of, you know, the Latino population, you know, it's like I said, it's becoming a thing now.
Yeah,
you know,
I mean, even one of my other friends was throwing his own De Los Muertos events, which I had to miss because this was coming up.
Right.
But it's a regular thing. Lots of groups are getting together and doing things, and stuff is happening. It's really catching fire.
It's what we bring to the table besides, you know, the good Mexican food. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I mean, you know, except for the sticker shock at the ticket prices, you know, I mean, I don't have anything bad to say about the show. I mean, I think it was, you know, for a first-time event, you know, everything seemed to be very well organized. You know, the panels were really interesting and neat to attend. For the sake of, you know, having something to complain about, I'll toss in my obligatory, you know, where were the badges complaint that I always beef on.
Yeah, the badges and
well, there weren't any. I mean, they drew something on our wrists like we're going to a bar or something. You know, it's like, wait a minute, I haven't had to do this crap since college, you know.
Yeah, a minor harp.
A minor, you know, thing to complain about. Yeah. Cause,
but it's something that can be easily remedied.
I hope that they do it again. I definitely, you know, would be interested in coming back. Hopefully the price would be a little more reasonable next time.
Well, and maybe do it like, they don't have to do it downtown, but they could probably, you know, some other place in town.
Yeah, just don't say the San Antonio Event Center.
No, not there.
Okay.
There are plenty of hotels that they could probably, you know, do it if they're going to, you know, take an investigation elsewhere.
Certainly the Manger. That's one that comes to mind.
Well, I think that one they probably tried for because I heard that, you know, just it's a very difficult to book stuff there.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they ask for outrageous prices. You know, as any other venue, it's like they're a ghost spot and they know it. And when they see those groups coming, you know, they up the prices.
Cha-ching. Yep.
Sort of like, you know, like walk being a steampunk and walking into a thrift store. They see you coming and they're going to, like, they know what you're there for. So they're going to up the prices on all their clocks. So, you know, that's what you're going to get.
Yeah. Or anything with any exposed gears.
Pretty much, yeah. The location was a good centralized location. It was a bit cramped, though. But then again, it was a sort of a more intimate event, so I didn't mind it too much.
Yeah, I don't think that they anticipated, you know, like a huge attendance. I mean, I don't have any record of what, you know, what the attendance was. I mean, I'll say it maybe 200 at most, if even, and that's being generous. I mean, I don't know how many folks showed up, but... But for the size of the space they had, it was a healthy crowd.
Yeah, it was a very good, I mean, there was a good number of people in there. And they were all having fun, and everybody looked like they were having a good time.
Yeah, definitely, and that's the whole point. You know, go, you know, have fun, learn some things about, you know, the supernatural or the paranormal. You know, and yeah, I enjoyed it. You know, like I said, I had a good time.
Yeah, definitely.
Anything else, Chris?
No, not too much.
Not too much. Yeah, I think we hit most of the bases. I mean, once again, you know, overall, good event. You know, a little steep on the price, but, you know, we were press. So, you know, take that for what it's worth.
Well, I mean, you know, it depends on we're sort of looking at it at a sort of a face value type of thing. Yeah, we really need to look at it from, like, well, you know, we're not really investigators ourselves, so we might not be getting as much out of it as, say, their target audience would be.
Yeah, but even then, I mean, that's not necessarily a bad thing because, like I said, I know nothing about almost nothing about this kind of stuff, and I enjoyed it. You know, I genuinely, you know, learned some things from the, you know, listening to the speakers and talking to them. You know, so I mean, like I said, even though I'm a complete newbie, you know, I thought it was neat. I thought it was interesting. I learned some things and had a good time. So, you know, yeah, I definitely say if they do it again. Even if you aren't, you know, very knowledgeable about, you know, these, you know, the paranormal, you know, whether it be ghosts or, you know, weird animals or what have you, it's a good chance to go and learn about this kind of stuff. You know, you might find it interesting. Who knows?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, even if you have a mild interest, it's worth it.
That's something neat. It's something it's different. Yeah, something definitely different and worth checking out. So yeah, that was the Dia de los Muertos Paranormal Conference. If you'd like more information, they don't quite have a website, but one of the organizers of the event is Linda Gonzalez Salazar, S-A-L-A-Z-A-R. You can find her on Facebook for more information on the event, or you know, if there's going to be another one. I haven't really heard anything as of yet, but definitely check her out. I'm Eduardo Soliz. My website is randomizer9.com, and of course you can check out the podcast on iTunes. And as for Chris Holm, he can be found at chrisholmcomics.com or deviantart.com/chrisholm, or actually that's chrisholm.deviantart.com.
Yeah, go ahead, check us out. And
yeah, I think that'll do it for this episode. So on behalf of Chris Holm and myself, thanks for listening.